keyword is the essence of SEO or search engine related any marketing. What does keyword mean? Keyword is someone is searching for a term. Now the people are searching for hundreds of terms, but there are certain terms which are searched more. Then we say that, oh, these terms are key terms, these are keywords, and we want to optimize our website for these keywords. And it can be even one search in a month can be key for you. For some people, only above 100 will be a key term for them. For some people, it can be 1000 plus, depends on which industry you are. So key means there are certain terms that people are searching. Out of this, certain terms are important for you. So it becomes a key term, keyword. Okay. And you have AdWords keyword tool to do an analysis to see how many people are searching for it. If you are an advertiser, then you'll get an advertiser account, and in advertiser account you'll be able to see the exact number of search that are happening for a keyword. If you do not have a advertiser account, then you will see only a suggestive range. It will say 0 to 10, 10 to 1000, or 1000 to 10,000 kind of a range, but it will not tell you whether it is a 1200 search volume or it is 9000 search volume. It will just give you a range. So getting a AdWord account is relatively simple. You can pay $5 into AdWords, use it, don't use it, etc. You can put your credit card and you can start some advertisement for your local blog, etc., whatever you want to do, and then you'll get the account, and then you can do all the keyword analysis using that account. Now let's assume that you have the access, and then how do you look at it? How do you do keyword analysis? So keyword analysis, the first part of keyword analysis is doing keyword discovery. So what do we mean by keyword discovery? How do people search in your industry? Example is, let's take the mobile phone industry. Are people searching for cell phone? Are people searching for mobile phone? Are people searching for smartphone? Or are people searching for just phones? Or people are searching for phone or telephone? What are people searching for? So you will do multiple keywords and then you will try to discover that, okay, people are searching for this type of keywords, that type of keywords, etc. And that you can cluster it. You can put into different clusters. Or maybe let me show you on the board if that helps you. Okay. Can you just show the board and see if that comes up well? All right. So can you see the board? Okay. So now let's look at it. So what I'm going to do is when I'm doing the discovery, the keyword discovery part, so I am going to put that into two grids. This is like the grids that we're going to have. Okay. So let's take an example. So what I'm going to put here is, I'll call this as dimensions. And then each of this dimension will have attribute. Okay. Now let's take a different example of Bollywood industry. So in Bollywood industry, what I'm going to look at is, one dimension is actor. Okay. Another dimension will be actress. So in actor, what are people searching for? People are searching for age, wife, past movies, etc. So these are all attributes to that dimension. The dimension is actors. Now how many people are searching for this? If you take, say, 10 actors, the top level actors, mid level actors, junior actors, then you will find out that how big the market is. Let's assume that for the top level actors, there is a 500,000 search that is happening on a monthly basis. In actress, what are people searching for in actress? Hairstyle. Hairstyle happens generally in Bollywood compared to Hollywood. In Hollywood, one of the top level searches for any actor or actress is around hairstyle, whereas in India it's more about sari. Okay, which sari she has wore. So they will say Deepika Padukone sarees, sari in movie, etc. And then there will be movies, then there will be age. They also look at height, like what is the height of the actress, etc. So these are all dimensions. If you select 10 actresses, you will find 7 or 8 attributes same, like biography, Wikipedia page, etc. So that will be the same. So you have dimensions, then you have attributes. Then what you're going to do is, what is the average search volume here? What is the average search volume here? Average search volume. So when you combine all of those keywords together, so I am getting a total of 5000K for actors. I am getting say around 9000K for actresses. And I'll have say some more attributes like movie, directors, news, etc. here dimension. So I'm going to put all of those things here. So in total, maybe here with directors and all, it will be 100K, and with movies and all, it can be say maybe 1000 or 1 million. 1 million plus kind of a search volume. So what I'm looking at is, this is my total search market, and this total search market is divided across these clusters, these buckets, these dimensions, these attributes. Now I need to look, so this is basically a segmentation of my search market with respect to search engine optimization, not from paid advertisement perspective, primarily from the overall search market perspective. Now whether I will do optimization on certain level, whether I will not do it, whether I'll put paid advertisement there, that is all my decisions. But this is how my search market looks like. Then my job is, if the market is really big here, now the next thing that I need to look at is that how competitive it is to rank for the actor's name in itself. Okay, so if I want to rank for Salman Khan, can I rank? It's very difficult to rank, because Salman Khan, the top page will be Salman Khan's official page, then you'll have a Salman Khan fan page, then you'll have a Salman Khan Facebook page, then you'll have a Salman Khan Twitter page, and by the time you are there, you might be on the second page or the third page, and nobody is bothered to go to the second and third page. So there is no point in optimizing for those keywords. But where do you optimize? Maybe the upcoming actors, they do not have such a popularity, your website is more popular than them. Maybe for them, those pages will be ranked better than the popular actors. So you will say upcoming actors as a page, and around upcoming actors you can link to their pages. But age, a lot of people are searching for it. Is their website more popular than your website? Maybe your website can be more popular than that. So around age, how will you create a, how do you map that with your website? So wherever you feel that there is big market for it and there is less competition for it, then you're going to map. So when you look at this, you will have to look at again two dimensions. How big is my market? How is my competition? So if this dimension is competition and this dimension is market, if my market is big, my competition is low, this is for sure the market to go for. If my market is low and my competition is also low, these are all short term, the long tail keywords, where you can get the ranking in short term, because the competition is also very small, the market is also very small, only 10 people, 20 people are searching for it. For B2B businesses, for businesses where your return from each keyword is very, very high, you may want to do it. But if you're into an entertainment industry, sometimes you may not want to focus too much on short, the you know, long tail keyword which has a very, very small search volume. And that is a question mark whether you want to go after these people or not. Where the competition is very high and the market is very low, probably you want to touch that very late. You don't want to touch that. Okay, like there can be examples of keywords where the market may be very high, like maybe 1 lakh people are searching for it, but it's not relevant for you. Okay, example is in our industry, SEO is a very, very highly competitive keyword. A lot of people have written article on this, a lot of people link to certain websites and etc. But people who search for SEO is not relevant for a digital marketing agency. Because people who are searching for it, 99% people are looking for information. They're not looking for a digital marketing agency. They want to learn SEO. So there's no relevant market for a digital marketing agency there. So you have a high competition but low relevant market. So again, this market is not market but relevant market for you. If there are 1 lakh people searching for you, and if you feel only 1% is relevant for you, so your relevant market is this 1000, not 1 lakh or 100,000, right? So that's what we are looking at. That, and these are the big keywords where your market is also very high, your competition is also very high. So what you're going to do is you will take the smaller keywords first, then you'll go to the next level, then you will go to the next level, and somewhere this will happen to you. You keep building for it, and the problem that happens is a lot of people only focus on this. Okay, now do you understand how the search engine has to be mapped